My name is Jiro Yamaguchi and I teach politics at Hosei University in Tokyo. I was president of Japanese Political Science Association in 2009.
Yeah. Well, it's great to have you in Sheffield. I'm really pleased to
meet you. My pleasure, yeah.
You mentioned that you first came across Bernard Crick's work very early.
Yeah, I entered the university in 1977. And in the first term, I read Bernard Crick's In Defense of Politics in seminar, of course in Japanese. And that was the first book of political science I read after entering university.
And I mean, what is happening, do you think, with political engagement? Are you concerned that something is going wrong?
Yeah. Let me briefly explain the recent development of Japanese politics. Japan is an example of predominant party system for a very long time. Conservative Liberal Democratic Party ruled Japan for nearly 50 years. But since the 1990s, Japan has been encountering a lot of problems such as the aging population, decrease of population, stagnation of the economy, and political initiatives are necessary to break the stalemate. And so people also longed for the political change. And in 2009, we had the first change of government in the post-war Japan. And the center-left Democratic Party of Japan took the government. And it did carry out several important policy changes, but it made a lot of mistakes, especially after the 311 great earthquake. It wasn't able to handle a lot of problems or disasters caused by the earthquake, especially the nuclear power plant accident.
Do you think that the public understand the essence of democratic politics?
Well, I must say, in the process of the change of government, I think the change of government was simplified. So, you know, the Japanese voters just switched from one party to another because old party didn't provide attractive policies. So, they also got disillusioned about the new government. So they, you know, returned to old ones. So, you know, I think the Japanese people are rather passive, and democracy is regarded as just, you know, voting or choosing between two major parties.
Okay. Well, the Crick Center is launching a campaign tomorrow called More Than a Vote, which is all about the fact that democracy is not just about voting. Mm-hmm. Do you think such a campaign would resonate in Japan?
Yes. And actually, there are some symptoms of hope. For example, after the great devastating accident of the Fukushima nuclear power plant, a lot of people started to rally on streets in Tokyo or other big cities. Mm-hmm. Japanese people didn't have a habit of making demonstrations or raising voices about public issues, but they witnessed that worst disaster in the human history, and they felt that it is their duty to raise voices about the nuclear policies.
And has that democratic energy been sustained? Is it still in evidence?
Yes, still consistent. Although under the current conservative government, the nuclear power policy returned to the rather normal or old style, but people are still alive about the making voices. So we are now watching the birth of a new political culture in Japanese society.
Okay. And do you sometimes think or wonder whether politicians become the lightning rods for a whole range of social frustrations about which politicians can't control?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very good point. And actually, in 2009, then government, Democratic Party of Japan, felt they are omnipotent because they were elected, they got landslide victory. But you know, their policy change is not a simple one. You know, there are many stakeholders, and you know, the political politics is not a game between good guy and bad guy. Or so there should be you know, deliberation and you know, processes consisting of you know, engagement or participation of various actors. So,
talking about that participation, one of the great pressures in the UK, but growing around the world, is for academics, for political scientists, to be more visible in society.
Right, right.
How visible are political scientists in Japan?
Well, since the 1990s, Japanese politics has been in a process of transformation. We had a party realignment, and we had electoral reform. So, some political scientists, including me, often appear in TV programs and write contribution to newspapers and magazines.
Okay.
So I think the political scientists played some important role in the process of political reform. But I must say, you know, there is a scientificism in Japanese political science.
Uh-huh. That is something that Bernard Crick was writing about. His PhD was all about the rise of science within the study of politics.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me ask you a final question. You're a specialist in politics. You understand how democracy works. Have you ever thought about giving up academic life and becoming a politician yourself?
Very difficult question. I nearly decided to run for election 2 times.
Oh.
But, you know, I was not able to get support from my family, or I decided to stay in the academic world and write many articles or books on the life of politics.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's been great to meet you. Thanks for coming to Sheffield.
My pleasure.
And let's stay in touch in the future.
Sure. Yeah.